What's up everyone, Clayton here, and today we are back with another Elder Scrolls Online video. This video, yes, I'm alive. This video is just gonna be a short little one, probably about 10-15 minutes, of me showing a rundown of a character, and maybe doing a quest or two, I guess? Just depending on, what we have to do. So, pretty much, this is my character. Oh shit, that was weird. It is, let's see, a character. Which one's gonna, okay, yep. So he is a high elf dragonite. Those are my attributes distribution. 31 in the health, 22 in the stamina or magicka. The reason I'm putting some more much points into magicka is because I use a lot of magicka abilities to, do damage. That's kind of what my main damage is magicka. And I'm a tank for the most part, so that's like what I'm gonna be doing in dungeons. So yeah, that's why I have so much in the health, and my boon is the Lord Stone, which increase maximum health. So I guess we can just go down the skill line here. So for one of my bars, my hot bars, I use a destruction staff. On that staff, I use engulfing flame. This is pretty good because it will make enemies take 10% extra damage from fire attacks, and most of my abilities with a Dragonite and destruction staff or fire destruction staff is fire, so it's gonna increase the damage a lot with that. My two is fire clinch. It deals damage and knocks back targets 8 meters and stuns them for 2.5 seconds. That's pretty much the only reason why I use this. It doesn't have a lot of damage on it, but the knockback is pretty good just to keep people off of me, especially melee guys who are trying to kill me. I am pretty tanky, so I don't really have to worry about, dying so much, but it's kind of nice to knock people away from me. My next one is an unstable wall of fire. It creates an elemental firewall that deals damage over, yeah. It's pretty much just a pretty much a fire like thing on the ground that just like lays a carpet of fire, and if they stand in it, they get, damage taken to them, fire damage, which is pretty good. And I forgot to mention I am veteran rank 5, so that's pretty cool. And my fourth ability is, if I get that on there, is Burning Talons. It immobilizes target nearby enemies for 4 seconds and deals damage. So yeah, this is pretty good. Just because for more CC, especially it works together with my 3 ability. If I use my 4 and then use the 3 underneath of it gets all the ticks of damage it can. And my 5, which is a destruction staff ability, is Fiery Pulsar. It deals damage and reduces their max health by 13% for 30 seconds, which is pretty good. That way you hit them with it once and they're drop down immediately by 13% of the maximum health, so you can do more damage to them. And my ult is probably the best ult in the game, Standard of Might. It's really good. Enemies take 125 flame damage every second and receive 50% less healing for 15 seconds. While on Standard of Might, caster deals 20% more damage and takes 20% less damage while on a Standard of Might. So that's pretty much why I use that, because if I get in a pickle, I just kind of pop that down. And I have a ability which every time I use my ultimate, I get some health and magicka back, so that's really good as well. So all of these abilities, this is, I think there's two abilities that are from the Ardent Flame ability from my class, which are Engulfing Flame and Burning Talons. For Ardent Flame here, I'll just go over this. I only have the Kindling and World and Flame passives. You can read what they do there. It does more damage, and this increases fire damage or fire area effect abilities. These three abilities are for my destruction staff. So, yeah. And my second hot bar is, at the moment, dual wielding. The only reason I'm doing dual wielding is because I already have my one-handed and shield at level 50, two-handed level 50, so I'm just going to dual wield next, just because that way I can get something else ranked up a little bit. So yeah, that's what I have right now. Here's my hotbar. There's some lightning in the background. We have Whirling Blades. It does AoE damage around me. This does damage over second, which is pretty good. So if I can keep this on people, they burn for a lot of damage. Burning Talons I had before, which is pretty good. This whip is also really good. It also sets people off balance, so yeah, or stun enemies off balance. So that means I can hit them again with the power attack and pretty much kill them. And then Green Dragon Blood heals me for 33% of missing health, increases health recovery by 40%, and stamina recovery by 30%. And I also have Standard of Might on this as well. So that's kind of what my hotbars are. I guess I can go into my armor. My armor has... I'm using heavy armor for the most part. You could hear my phone go off a second ago, but don't ignore that. I have all the passives for heavy armor, just because that's what I use. I also have medium and light armor pretty high up, just because I might want to switch to a full DPS later on, so that's why I have these as backups, in case I need to use them. Soul magic, I don't really have up that much. These guild things don't really matter. For my race souls, I have all my race souls maxed out, so that's pretty good. Increase experience gain with destruction staffs, magicka recovery, increase magicka, and increase damage with cold, fire, or shock effects by 4%, which is pretty good. So if you want to be a mage, it's pretty good. My build I'm using is kind of a like a fire mage, so a dark elf would probably be better at it since they have a bonus to fire damage, but high elf is probably the second. And for craft, I'm using blacksmithing, clothing, and woodworking. I haven't really gotten anything else. I just use these because I want to make sure I have weapons and armor to make sure I don't die a bunch. So yeah, that's pretty much what my build is. I can show you some of my class. See, each class has a different, you know, three different parts of it. This is Ardent Flame, which is like more of the damage. I have the Draconic Power, which is more of the tankiness. And Earthen Heart is more of the support. So I don't really have much into this. This is what I was talking about earlier. I restore health and magic and stamina when I cast my ultimate. So that's pretty good. I also have some of these other passives that make sure that I am a little bit more tanky and more damage. And I might end up picking up one of these just because it gives 2 seconds more to my ultimate and my Shearing Strike and my Fire Breath, which I use on different hotbars that I use. I'm gonna shut my phone off. There we go. And one, I probably should get this too, which is causing damage to armor's frame ability, snares to target, which would be pretty good as well. So that's kind of what my guy is looking at for abilities. For weapons, not the really best. I got the Plague's Mask, which I pretty much all my items have health enchantments, just because I don't feel like dying. And some of them have magicka, that's just because this is a better thing to have than what I have on right now. And yeah, see, these aren't the best items. I'm probably just gonna get max level and then get items. But yeah, so I'm running 5 heavy, 1 light, and 1 medium. That way I get all my passives from my heavy armor, but I also get to level up my light armor and medium armor up a little bit. So that's pretty cool. And for accessories, I have Ruby Necklace of Reducing Spell Costs, which it reduces magic cost by 18, increases health. This increases health and health recovery. And this gives 250 spell resistance and increases magic by 49. It's pretty, like, this is a kind of an old, it's a level 40 ring. I should probably upgrade it, but I really like the 250 spell resistance just because I don't like getting hit by spells that much. And like I said, I have a flame staff as well as a mace, or dual maces for one-handed. So yeah, that's kind of what my character is right now. And as you see, I am a high elf, so I'm a part of the Altmeri Dominion. But right now, we are in the Daggerfall area. The reason is that because I've already completed the high elf, or the Altmeri Dominion, or the high elf starting zone, and I've already completed all of the Ebonheart pack. And I get the quest now, if I hit J, called Cadwell's Gold, which means I get to start from the Daggerfall Covenant. So I figured this is probably a good place to start, you know, this little series, if I want to continue this, just because I'm getting a completely new start, a new fresh start. So yeah. So what pretty much happened so far is that I showed up in that building right there, and I walked out, and you've kind of seen straight up what I've seen from starting this. So yeah. I guess we can talk to some of these people here. This has a quest icon above her head, so it must be important. Do I know you? Where is Captain Kaleen? Okay. If you want to lend a hand, talk to our bosun, Gilzy. He's on deck. We'll go to the boatswain then. So, he was talking about going to Stroth Mackay. And Stroth Mackay is the starting island for the Daggerfall Covenant. Which means, like, each... I can show you a little bit here. Each starting place has its own starting area. Like here, Canarthi's Roost was the starting island. You would spawn here on the main island, but you would come over here as kind of a beginning. And for as well as up here, you would come up here to Breakwalk Isle for the Ebonheart Pact. So we probably end up doing that first, just to get that content out of the way. It is a starting zone, so it means it's probably not the most rigorous thing I could be doing, but I kind of want to get done with that, because I'm kind of a person who would want to... Oh, I'm going the wrong way. I'm not really good at the map. I'm going to be bringing up the map a lot, because that's how I kind of how I play. I like to look at the map. Anyways, what was I saying? Oh, it's a starting zone, so you don't expect it to be a bunch of content that's hard or difficult. It does rank up with me, and for whatever reason, I am a level behind what I should be. If I wanted to be here right now, I should be veteran level 6, but I'm only veteran level 5 for whatever reason. I don't know why it's like that, because I've done all the content. I've completed every single quest on the Ebonheart Pact, as well as every single quest in the Altmeri Dominion. But I figure it's because I haven't done very many dungeons, which is something I kind of want to get to after I beat the single player or the PvE side of it. And then I'll go into more of the dungeon PvE and then go into PvP if I feel like it. So yeah, I'm starting to get back into this game, and I'm having quite a lot of fun with it. So, let's see here. We gotta talk to the boatswain here. How may I serve? I need to find Captain Colleen. Yeah, take me to Stroth Mackay. So, yeah, we are on our way to Stroth Mackay. This is a Hammerfell island, I believe. Let's read this right here. One of the first landfall settlements by the Red Guards, so yep, when they sailed east from their lost home of Yakuta. The island, Stroth Mackay. So yeah, we are here, and this is like the starting island. It's not the biggest thing ever, and probably doesn't have the most, things to do, but we'll make sure we can clear out most of this. So yeah, I've been talking a lot, but I haven't really asked you guys what you're thinking about this, or Let's Play, I guess you could say. I'm not really sure if people are really into the Elder Scrolls Online. I feel like the fan base is kind of deteriorating a little bit because it wasn't really... just because it's not really the game people really wanted, so... Yeah. But anyways, let's go ahead and talk to Colleen. There's orcs, and here's Colleen. You saved me? Really? I just fished you out of the water. Master Kassan got you breathing again. The important thing is you're alive. But if you're feeling grateful, I could use some help. Help with what? A job. Anyone who helps is going to get rich. Right. Okay. Now, I need a fresh face. Someone this island's butcher in charge, Headman Bosek, doesn't know and won't stop. Basically, you recruit the folks I need, you get a cut of the take. All right, now help you out. The folks I need are Crafty Larissa, Jakarn, and Naramo. Any or all of them would do.
Okay, tell me about Jakarn. He's a thief. Okay. He'd be a big help in the heist I have planned. Problem is, he robbed Bosek. Nobody robs Bosek. He's been tossed into the grave under Bosek's palace. I'll look for Jakarn then. How do I get to him? Okay. Alright, who runs Stroth Mackay? Okay. He took over the palace years ago, killed the old ruler and took his place. No one stands up against him? Captain Helene, but she's worse than Bosek. Her sea drakes run Saintsport, south of here. Biggest band of murderers on the sea. Bosek and Helene. Okay. Well, that's good enough for me. So yeah, it's kind of what you guys, what I was talking about earlier was I kind of want your guys' opinion. If you guys want to see this more of it, I will do it because I kind of been getting into playing this game a little bit more. So yeah, we'll probably do this one quest and then call it good. So let's get going.
So yeah, if you guys don't know much about this game, there's three factions that are fighting each other, which I kind of talked about earlier. I have the Altmeri Dominion, which I am a part of, and the Ebonheart Pack, as well as the Daggerfall Covenant. Our Altmeri Dominion consists of the High Elves, the Wood Elves, and the Khajiit. And the Ebonheart Pack consists of the Dark Elves, the Argonians, and the Nords. And here where we are now is the Red Guards, or the Daggerfall Covenant is the Red Guards, the Bretons, and the Orcs. So that's pretty much who we're all going to be seeing for the most part here. And there's a High Elf there, which kind of throws off everything. But yeah, this is where the factions, or those people will probably be seeing the most out of anyone that we come across. So yeah. Let's go ahead and find Jakarn in here, and we've got to watch out for these traps. And hopefully we get to fight some people so I can show off this build a little bit, because I pretty much like it. It's pretty good. I gotta remember, it's not Skyrim, so I need to not, you know, use my ultimate when I am trying to cast abilities. So right here, that is my 3 ability that was on the ground there. And yeah, I'm just pretty much gonna try to just kill these guys. Oh, there's a power attack, and he's dead. And I'll go ahead and kill this guy now. Yeah, see, I do quite a little bit of damage for being mostly a tank. And that's pretty much how I play this, is I put my 3 down, make sure I CC them into my fiery wall. That way they can't get out, and they get the full tankiness of my damage. So let's see, we'll shoot this guy through the fire here. Try to hop over the fire. So we're going to pass our Jagged Talons and use our thing there. And then we just kind of spam abilities until he's dead. Which is pretty good. I like it. And let's see. We'll try to use our dual wield a little bit here. I'm just going to make sure I get my health regen back, because it'd be kind of embarrassing to die. So I'm going to hit him with that and then spin around a bunch. And spin around. Okay, so that little noise there, that means my ultimate is up. So I can get my ultimate and use that sometime if I get the hang of it. So we're gonna whip this guy. Oh yeah, I forgot to ask, if you guys have any... Oh, this chick's in the wall. Come on, Gabe, I'm trying to make you look good, and now you're doing this to me. Oh yeah, what I was gonna say was, if you guys have any better suggestions for my build, go ahead and leave them in the comments. I'm by any means the best Elder Scrolls Online player. Probably not even in the top, like, million. But, I don't know if a million people play this game. But, yeah, I could always use some suggestions on what you guys think is a better build. So, yeah. Because this one, I like this one just because, I don't know, I like it. I kind of took most of the strategy from this guy I used to watch right when this game came out, which is a Force Strategies gamer. I think that's what his YouTube is. But I kind of took some of what he does here, but not like, I don't think, he used like light armor, and he was a dark elf, and he was full, DPS, for PvE anyways. But yeah, that's kind of what I'm kind of running here too. I like it, so I'm probably going to keep using it, unless someone tells me that I'm doing it completely wrong. Until then, I'm probably just going to keep running this build. Okay, so we'll go talk to Jakarn. You have to help me. Okay. That's not good. Hopefully that didn't mess up the recording that much. Had a pop-up there. Well, that's perfect. Get me out of here, and I'm at your service. Okay, yeah. Okay. Is that really important right now? Sure, I took that gem, but he took it from some poor merchant. Tossed him in here to die. Can't steal from a thief, can you? Alright, I'll get you out. So, can we open this gate? Free Jakarn. Can we unlock cell door? No, not talk to him. Get me out of here. Can we... There we go. Free Jakarn. Jakarn. Whatever. Yes, you do. Let's get out of here. Let's get out of here. Do we need to go the same way? Looks like it. And just like any MMO, all the enemies that we pass will spawn again. So that's kind of annoying, I guess. And it's kind of slow in here. Usually there's a group of three or four people, but now it's kind of just one guy. Oh, we need to go this way. Where did he go? I'm blind. It says, is there an up part of it? Or going down somewhere? Is it to climb this up here? Where did he go? Jackie. Jackie. Where did you go, Jackie? Where did he go? It says to go that way. Do we need to go down farther? I don't understand. Okay. Well, I'm probably just gonna cut back to figure out where I'm gonna go. So yeah, I'll see you guys in a second. Okay, so I've been kind of just running around. It looks like I just need to go back the way it came. The map just kind of confused me there. But what I'm gonna try to do here, which might get me killed, is I'm gonna try to get a big group of enemies up around here, so I can kind of show you that this build's pretty good on taking out an AoE. So I'm gonna press my 4 and then press my ult, and then I'm just gonna spam my 5, which is this pulsar around me, and that kind of. You can see there that I kind of just insta-gibbed everyone in that little radius there. And I'm getting increased healing, as well as they took damage. So hopefully we can kill this last archer. And there we go. So yeah, that was pretty good. I took a lot of damage, but I'm no nearly, like, not even close to being dead or anything, so. I have that going for me, which is nice. Now we just gotta get past these traps. We'll pop our heal a little bit so we don't have to worry about getting hit anymore, and we'll just probably waltz right out of here. Is this where we need to go? Yes, it is. Yeah, I don't know what I was thinking earlier. It looks like the map is just kind of confusing, or I'm just dumb. I'm gonna go with I'm dumb. So, okay, so we're out of that grave. Let's talk to Karn. Why not? Okay, so a side exit. Where do we need to go? Okay, right around the corner. So we just need to go through here, it looks like. Is that any. What is that? Bottle? Okay, nothing. I'm not really gonna loot anything, because there's not really much to loot. I feel like that's kind of what people don't really like about this game, is because it's so not much like a Elder Scrolls game, to the point where you're like, you can do everything you can do in Skyrim and stuff. You gave something to goblins?
I figure if you want something kept safe, give it to the goblins. The locals are
Okay.
stupid to trade it, and they'll kill anyone who tries to take it.
Won't they kill you if you try to take it?
You went through a lot of trouble to free me, right? There's no way you'll let me get eaten by goblins. So you, my good friend, will follow me to their mine. Yeah?
Okay. Let's see. Let's check, see how much I have on my recording here. It's getting pretty late in the recording, so I'm gonna go ahead and stop it right here. If you guys wanna see more of me playing this game, just make sure you say it in the comments down below. And if you don't wanna see it, or you don't wanna watch me play this game, just say, yo, don't play this game anymore on here. I'll probably end up playing more of it myself, but I figured since I'm just at a good spot to kind of start a Let's Play that I would start it. So yeah. I wanna thank you guys for watching, and make sure you leave your feedback in the comments. I'm gonna mention that one more time, and yeah, thanks for watching, and yeah, I don't know what to say here. I guess I'll see you guys later. This is Clayton, messing up an outro, and signing off.